Good afternoon, family. You might hear my grandson's show in the background. Before I jump into the article, I'm going to read from John 5. This is going to be 1 through 10. After this, there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now there is a Jerusalem by the sheep market, a pool, which is called in the Hebrew tongue Bethesda, having five porches. In these lay a great multitude of impotent folk, of blind, halt, withered, waiting for the movement of the water. For an angel went down at a certain season into the pool and troubled the water. Whosoever then first after the troubling of the water stepped in was made whole of whatsoever disease he had. Just one second. And a certain man was there which had an infirmity, 38 years. When Jesus saw him lie and knew that he had been now for a long time in that case, he said unto him, Wilt thou be made whole? The impotent man answered him, Sir, I have no man when the water is troubled to put me into the pool, but while I am coming, another steppeth down before me. Jesus said unto him, Rise, take up thy bed and walk. And immediately the man was made whole and took up his bed and walked. And on the same day was the Sabbath. The Jews therefore said unto him that was cured, It is the Sabbath day. It is not lawful for thee to carry thy bed. When we are sick, when we have ailments, we put our faith and trust in Jesus. He gets us through. He's gotten me through. Maybe you can relate. You just seem like you go from one illness to another. But he's always there to take care of us. When you accept Jesus as Lord and Savior, the Holy Spirit dwells in you. He guides you. He strengthens you. He lifts you up. He is our everything. And whatever you're going through, if you're sick, he will strengthen you. He will get you through. Don't put your faith and trust in anyone or anything in this world. Put your faith and trust in Jesus. We are about to go home so soon. Between now and the rapture, it's going to keep getting worse. That's not doom and gloom. It's doom and gloom for the world. For us, we're going home. So whatever you go through, stay close to Jesus. I promise you, we'll get you through. This is from Mornings 247. This just came out. North Korean forces have attacked the South Korea with defense pact in place. New front. North Korean forces attack South Korea with defense pact in place. And Russian Pacific fleet is in firing position. 40 Russian warships in combat position near South Korea and Japan. South Korea summons Russian ambassador for explanation. All hell's about to break loose. I really feel like as the bombs drop, we go up. I really feel that. Sorry, one second. Still having a little trouble breathing. Another front between the superpowers is being activated on the planet. For the third time this month, North Korean troops have crossed the de facto border of South Korea, forcing South Korean forces to open fire with warning shots. This time, there is a telling difference, as the Russia-North Korean defense pact is in full effect, and the Russian Pacific Fleet is simulating a major naval confrontation near South Korea and Japan. I think they're about to go into a... I think eventually, they're probably already involved with China, but I think it's a matter of time before China goes into Taiwan. But satisfying, easy stream. Oh. That's an ad, I'm sorry. I've been having trouble sleeping lately, too. Just another one of my many ailments. I've barely slept for 2 days. I mean, I've been up since 4:30 tonight. I've been up since, yesterday was since 5 o'clock. Satisfying, easy stream. Three things that restrict and block stream. And so, do. Never mind that. That was an ad. I feel like a ninny bonehead. Okay, North Korean soldiers within the demilitarized zone. Try and say that 3 times. In the central sector of the front, cross the military separation line. After warnings and warning shots from our military, the North Korean soldiers withdrew to the north. South Korea's National Defense General Staff said, according to which today's incident was recorded at around 11 o'clock, General Mountain Time. Relations between North and South Korea have reached their worst point in decades. From a technical point of view, yes, baby. Okay, thank you. Do you want one? Okay, please. From a technical point of view, the two states remain at war as the war between them was 1950-1953 was only ended by a simple... Hold on, baby. Sorry. By a peace treaty that was never signed, basically. Here you go. Thank you.
Thank you.
Here you go. Yummy. This was the third border violation by North Korea this month. Previously, a group of 20 to 30 North Korean soldiers entered other areas of the central part of the border on June 9th and 18th, respectively. The border violations have come as North Korea has deployed large numbers of troops in frontline areas and is conducting a range of activities, including mine laying and building anti-tank barriers. It seems that North Korea is preparing and strengthening its first line of defense along the border. General war alert in the Russian Pacific Fleet. The timing of the back-and-forth security incidents between North and South Korea is notable. For days now, the Russian Pacific Fleet, after the Mediterranean, Baltic, and Northern fleets, has left the naval bases and is conducting large exercises in the Pacific Ocean and near South Korea and Japan. Video released by Russia's Defense Ministry shows several ships and a submarine sailing out to sea in the far eastern city of... Oh, I'm going to spell this out. VLADIVOSTOK. Next to North Korea, an operational base of Russia's Pacific Fleet. According to the Russian Ministry of Foreign Affairs, Pacific Fleet forces began deploying at sea as part of the exercise, which will be held from June 18th to the 28th in the Pacific Ocean, Sea of Japan. The exercises involve 40 ships and support ships, all coastal anti-ship arrays, BAL, B-A-L, and Bastion, B-A-S-T-I-O-N, about 20 aircraft and helicopters of the naval aviation, including anti-submarine aircraft Tu-142MZ, anti-submarine and SAR helicopters Ka-29 and Ka-27. Marine units of the Pacific Fleet also participate in the exercises. The exercises will be led by Commander of the Pacific Fleet, Admiral Victor Liina, L-I-I-N-A. Did you drink your other one? Let me see. You drank the whole thing already? Oh, here, there's a little bit more. So I'm sorry. Sailors will practice anti-submarine operations, learn to organize the defense of ships during sea passage, and conduct joint missile attacks on groups of ships of a simulated enemy. During the exercises, military personnel will practice repelling attacks from enemy unmanned aerial vehicles and unmanned vessels, and will also perform a set of practical combat training exercises. They got a lot of videos here. Loss of submarine Yasin in the Barents Sea. At the same time, along the Pacific Fleet, mobilization also exists in the Northern Fleet. The Russian Ministry of Defense has released footage of cruise missiles launches from the Yasin 885 class. Oh, I'm going to spell this out. S-E-V-E-R-O-D-V-I-N-S-K. And Oriole class. Oscar II and 949A nuclear-powered submarines of the Northern Fleet in the Barents Sea. The missile launch was carried out in accordance with the battle plan of the forces of the Northern Fleet. As a result of the missile launch, amphibious ships of a virtual enemy were hit at a distance of about 170 kilometers. Object control data confirmed that the shot was successful. The exercise was carried out by ships of the COLA, K-O-L-A, fleet, of the combined forces of the Northern Fleet. South Korea summons Russian ambassador for an explanation. I don't think they're going to tell him exactly what's going on. You know, I guess it's worth trying, you know, but they ain't going to send out some. It's not like Putin's going to go, okay, come here, man. This is what me and King Jong, whatever his name is, we're talking about. He's not going to say that. South Korean media reports that the Ministry of Foreign Affairs summoned the Russian ambassador for an explanation. South Korea requests an explanation on the issue of the signing of the defense agreement between Pyongyang and Moscow. They got tweets and everything here. All hell's about to break loose. I mean, for real. Yes, baby. If you heard that, I'm so sorry. One second, I got to pause this. He has to go potty. Okay. I'm sorry, he has to go potty. But yeah, all hell's about to break loose. But we are still here, the restrainer, the church. I'm not saying for sure the rapture is going to happen this year, but there's a pretty good chance it will. This year, next year. Whatever we go through between now and the rapture, stay close to Jesus. He will strengthen you and he will get us through. Because I'm going to be looking for you at the marriage supper. At the brownie table. I love you guys. I'll leave the link in the description box. Have a wonderful weekend. God bless you. And I'll talk to you soon.